Maybe you've been wondering this too. If dragons existed, how fast would they fly? Fortunately for us, Julian was looking into this while researching the MinuteEarth video about dragon biology. If you think about it though, the question itself is a bit vague. After all, creatures can fly at many different speeds. But there is a more specific question that's easy enough to answer. What's the minimum speed at which they'd have to fly in order to stay in the air? If you've ever thrown a paper airplane, for example, you may have gotten a sense that there's a minimum speed you have to throw it at before it can really soar. We can apply that principle to any large-winged creature, including dragons. So what's the minimum flight speed of a dragon? Well, Julian did the math, and it varies from dragon to dragon. So I decided to put together a lab that lets you compare the flight speed of various flying things side by side. It turns out that when you look at the average minimum flight speeds of large flying animals like birds and compare it to their weight and wing size, they all tend to follow a trend that can be plotted on a graph like this. Using this trend, Julian was able to calculate the theoretical flight speed for a bunch of flying things that we added to this lab. Generally, the heavier the thing is, the faster it needs to fly to stay airborne. You can see in the lab that the big things need to fly faster. But this isn't a rule. For example, if you compare the wandering albatross to the Canada goose, the albatross can fly slower, even though it's a bigger animal. This is because weight isn't the only factor at play. The size of the wings matters too. Larger wings means more lift, which allows for a lower minimum flight speed. This is why the albatross can fly slower. It has much larger wings compared to its weight than the Canada goose. The lab lets you move creatures around and even launch them to get them flying along a different track. But you'll have to make sure that you give them enough speed when you do, otherwise, well, you get the idea. As usual, you can find the flight speed lab at MinuteLabs.io, or you can click on the link up here or in the video description. And of course, thanks again to those of you who donate on Patreon. It really helps. Have fun with the lab, and I'll see you soon with something new.